Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam. I am Unnati and today I am going to narrate the first chapter of Krishna book, that is the advent of Lord Krishna. Before proceeding, let me tell you what are we going to do in this video. First, we will see why did Lord Krishna appear on the earth and what exactly happened before Lord Krishna's advent. So let's proceed to our story. Before, there were a lot of unnecessary forces by the demoniac kings on the earth. Bhumi Devi was totally feeling very bad about it. So she went to Lord Brahma and narrated all her problems. Lord Brahma felt very pity on her. So he, along with all the Devi Devatas, went to Lord Vishnu, who resides in the Shweta Dvipa's milk ocean. By standing on the shore of Shweta Dvipa, they started singing the Purusha Sukta prayers. In spite of all their prayers, Lord Vishnu wouldn't come. So that time, Brahma personally sat and started meditating. There was a heart transformation of messages from Vishnu to Lord Brahma, and Brahma narrated it to the Devatas. The message was that the Supreme Personality of Godhead would appear in the Yadu dynasty. So, you all must appear on the earth in pious families to assist Lord Krishna. This is the scenario there in Shweta Dvipa. Now, let us come back to our earth. Shurasena was the king of Mathura, whose capital was Mathura, and this was the capital city of Yadu dynasty. The son of Shurasena, Vasudev, was married to Devaki, who is the daughter of Devaka. The Devaka gave a lot of dowry, which is 400 elephants, 15,000 horses, 18,800 chariots and 200 maidservants to follow Devaki. When the marriage was over, very nice musical instruments were played, which sounded very nicely. Then the Kamsa, son of Ugrasena, in order to please his sister, drove the chariot from Mathura to the capital city of Yadu dynasty. So that time there was an Akashvani made. It said that, "You fool Kamsa, you are driving the chariot of your sister whose eighth child is going to kill you." Hearing the statement, Kamsa was totally terrible. He turned into a demoniac person who was a very responsible brother. He just held the hair of Devaki and took his sword in order to cut her head, kill her. Vasudev, looking at this, he was totally horrified. He was thinking, "What should I do?" And he immediately pleaded Kamsa. He said, "You are a very great warrior and a vigilant king. Why are you committing such a defaming act of killing a woman who is your sister on the auspicious occasion of her wedding? Why are you so much afraid of death? When you are born, only your death is destined and no one can change it. Death is nothing but changing of bodies. Just like during sleep we go from one body to another, forgetting our original one. The same thing is death. The reflection of the moon is seen on the water. The moving water makes the moon move, appear to move, when actually it is not moving. The same way mental concoctions, we attain different bodies even though we have no connection with it. Because of Maya, we feel that we are these bodies." Like this, Vasudev gave many, many philosophical points. But Kamsa wouldn't listen because he was a demon. Vasudev thought, "It is better to take care of the present now. That is, we'll save Devaki. And if at all I have a child, then that time I'll see how to safeguard that child." So he told Kamsa, "Your sister is not going to kill you. It is her children. It is her eighth child who is going to kill you, who is not at all existing now. If we get any child in future, we will give it to you so that you can do the necessary action." So that time Kamsa agreed to whatever was said. And when the first child was born to Vasudev, he kept his word of honor and took the first child to Kamsa. And Kamsa that time felt very pity on the first child. And he said that, "Vasudev, it is the eighth child who is killing me and not the first child. So you can keep the first child with you. I am giving it back." So Vasudev felt very happy, but demoniac people are not at all true in their words. So Vasudev, he took the child anyways, he took it back. Then Narad Muni came. He came to accelerate the birth of Krishna. So as soon as he knew that Kamsa had given back the first child to Vasudev, so he said, he went to Kamsa immediately and said that, why did you give the first child back? The Devi Devatas have already appeared in the families of Yadu dynasty and many other pious families. So Lord Krishna might appear at any time. He just came to tell this. Kamsa immediately after hearing the word Devi Devata, he understood that yes, when Devi Devatas came, then Krishna would surely come. So he immediately imprisoned his father Ugrasena, his sister and brother-in-law Vasudev and Devaki, took the first child and killed it. And like this, the first six children of Vasudev and Devaki were killed. And the next comes the seventh and the eighth child, whom we all love very much. So their appearance and the prayers chanted by the demigods before their appearance will be told in the second chapter, that is the next video. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.